Hello friends, welcome to my channel CA Aman Gupta. Friends, today in our video we will be guiding you towards the analysis of e-way bill provisions under GST. Friends, e-way bill is electronic way bill. Electronic way bill is basically a compliance mechanism wherein by the way of digital interference the person causing the movement of goods uploads the relevant information prior to the commencement of movement of goods and generate e-way bill on the GST portal. Friends, the most important line, e-way bill is document required to be carried by a person in charge of the conveyance carrying any consignment of goods of value exceeding ₹50,000. Friends, this line means that if the invoice value is exceeding 50,000, then we have to prepare the e-way bill. That does not mean that the taxable value need to be of 50,000. Only the invoice value need to be of ₹50,000 and not more than that. Okay friends, now friends, these are the need and benefits of e-way bill. Friends, the most important part that the stakeholders of e-way bill. Friends, there are four stakeholders of e-way bill: supplier, recipient, transporter and the government. Friends, who need to create e-way bill? Friends, if we just clearly go through the provisions of e-way bill as per the GST law, then we will come to know that the e-way bill need to be prepared either by the supplier, recipient or the transporter. But friends, as per some of the few big top law corporate houses, I won't be taking their names, they said that the e-way bill need to be prepared by the transporter, or the onus of creating e-way bill lies over the transporter. Friends, according to me and according to my interpretation, even I will also say that during the time of movement of goods, we need to create e-way bill. And friends, the movement basically depends over the transporter. So we can interpret it very easily that whenever the goods are in the phase of movement from one place to another, only the transporter is responsible for that. So since the transporter is responsible for the movement of goods, therefore the generation of e-way bill or the onus of generating e-way bill also lies towards the transporter. Friends, even I have got one slide in this particular PPT over transporter. So we will be reaching out over there in coming time. But friend, it does not mean that we cannot prepare e-way bill. The word we over here comes as a supplier or the recipient. E-way bill need to be created either by three of them, from either by the supplier, recipient or the transporter. Now friends, who, when and who should prepare part A of e-way bill? Friends, the part A of e-way bill need to be created by every registered person who caused the movement of goods on consignment value exceeding ₹50,000 in relation to a supply, or for other reason other than supply, or due to inward supply from an unregistered person. Friends, if we do not have the registered GSTN ID of the transporter, or if we are moving goods for our own purposes, or the goods are being moved either by the rail or by the air or by the vessel, then in that particular case we need to prepare part B of e-way bill. Friends, what is part A and what is part B will be clearly defined to you in the practical session of generating e-way bill, which we will be uploading very shortly at our channel. Now friends, unique e-way bill number. Friends, upon the generation of e-way bill on the common portal, a unique e-way bill number will be generated by the common portal, which shall be made available to the supplier, recipient and the transporter on the common portal. E-way bill number is 12 digital numeric unique number. Friends, any person can verify the authenticity or the correctness of e-way bill by entering the e-way bill number, e-way bill date, generator ID and the dock number in the search option of e-way bill portal. Friends, how can we update, or whether the e-way bill can be updated, can get update or not? Friends, it can get update very easily. Where the goods are transferred from one conveyance to another, and in the case the conveyance get changed, then we can update the e-way bill by entering the e-way bill number at the e-way bill portal. Friends, when the updation is not required, where the goods are transported for a distance of less than 10 kilometers within the state or the union territory from the place of business or transport or finally to the place of business to the consignee, the details of conveyance may not be updated on the EV bill. Now friends, what happens when the transporter gets changed? The consignor recipient who has furnished the information in part A of form GST EV bill 01 or the transporter may assign the EV bill number to another registered transporter for updating the information in part B of the EV bill number. Provided that once the details of conveyance has been updated by the transporter in part B of form GST EV bill 01, the consignor or the recipient, as the case may be, who furnished the information in part A shall not allow to assign the EV bill number to another transporter. Friends, this means that sometimes what happens that if we are transporting or if we are into the phase of movement of goods from one place to another, then what happens that there are multiple transporter. For example, let us take an example that we need to move a particular goods from Delhi to Jodhpur. In the case of Delhi to Jodhpur, sometimes what happens that the particular goods is being first moved to Jaipur at the Jaipur Transport Nagar. And after from that particular place, the small transportation or the big transportation, depending upon the size of the material, is being further moved to the Jodhpur area or the Jodhpur district. In this particular case, we will be giving a particular contract of transporting only to one transporter, not to two transporters or not to more than one transporter. In this particular case, whenever we are preparing the EV bill in part A, we only write down the GSTN number of the main transporter. Then the further that particular transporter updates or makes the mandatory changes in the EV bill number by entering the vehicle number in part B of the second transporter. Now friends, if we see rule 138 sub rule 7, then we will come to know that the ultimately transporter is only responsible for generating EV bill. Friends, here you can see where the consignor or the consignee has not generated form GST EV bill 01 in accordance with the provisions of sub rule, then the transporter shall generate EV bill on the basis of invoice, bill of supply, delivery challan, and may also generate consolidated EV bill in form GST EWB 02 prior to the movement of goods. Friends, if we see over here in the pink column or the highlighted one, you can see in the case of e-commerce, where the goods to be transported are supplied through an e-commerce operator, the information in part A of form GST EWB 01 may be furnished by such e-commerce operator. Okay friends, now friends, cancellation. See, once the EV bill has been formed, then it can be cancelled within 24 hours of its generation. Okay friends, so it does not happen that if we have by chance mistakenly, or if we have put some sort of incorrect information in our EV bill, then we cannot cancel it. We can easily cancel it, but the cancellation time is only 24 hours within the generation. Now, validity of EV bills. Friends, if the particular goods which have to be transported within the country is up to first 100 kilometers, then the validity period is 24 hours. Okay, friends. Now, for the next every 100 kilometers, the additional 24 hours will be allotted. So for example, if we are transporting a particular goods from Delhi to Agra, so the distance from Delhi to Agra is 200 kilometers. So this means that the validity of EV bill will be of 48 hours. 48 hours how? For the first 100 kilometers, it will be 24 hours. And for every 100 kilometers or part thereof, it will be additional 24 hours. So 200 kilometers is equivalent to 48 hours. Now friends, this is over here the acceptance of EV bill. Now friends, the details of EV bill generated under sub rule shall be made available to the supplier or the recipient. Okay, on the common portal, and the supplier or the recipient, if the case may be, shall communicate his acceptance or rejection of the consigned value. Now friends, if once the EV bill has been generated, supposing it, let's take an example, I'm a supplier. Okay, no, I am a supplier, either the supplier or the recipient or the transporter can make the EV bill. Now in my case, let me take an example that I am only preparing the EV bill. Now once I have prepared the EV bill, then the government will send a notification to both, to my recipient.